Buddy, today is the November 29th, and did a little reading this morning in my Bible here, in Titus, Faith and Good Works. I read all of it, actually, the whole thing. It's a very short chapter. It's a good chapter. Somebody sent me an email and said to read it, which I have, and you know, no matter how many times you read it, It's always got something that refreshes your mind to everything. Okay? Like here in Titus 2, the second chapter, I'm going to go to 11 to 15. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. In other words, it's passing. We're passing through here, okay? And that's something we should know, that this was never meant to last. This is not meant to last. Looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, I can't tell you how many people I've walked up to and said, you know, this is the time. The time's at hand. And they said, I hope not. You know, and I'm like, wow, you know, how could you hope not? I mean, that's like condemning yourself. Because the Word of God says we should be looking forward to His coming. Who gave Himself for us, that we might be redeemed, that He might redeem us from all iniquity, and purify unto Himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. These things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. Okay. And you guys see, I've got a lot of people on here that really don't like me at all. And, you know, the only thing I can say about that is God help them, you know. That they might see the truth, you know, learn to see the truth. When they call this a blasphemy, you know. And then you see at the end of the trumpet, the white horse with the bathtub. When they're saying that this is all false, fake, and everybody knows he works with sevens. This was taken in 77 when I was 17. You know, the only thing I can think is demonic spirits. You know, they're hot and heavy right now. It's really bad because I believe we're at that point where we're getting ready to go. I'm pretty sure we are. My last dream, I seen, I guess, like, they were stars, but they were burning, coming down on the earth. There's so many of them. I was flying up off the ground. In other words, I don't believe I was on the earth when it happened, but I was above the earth where I could see it coming. Okay? I mean, when I say I was above, I'm going to say I was like up in the air, and I could see them just shooting down really hard and fast. Let no man despise thee. Put them in mind. This is chapter 3. Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers, to obey magistrates, to be ready to every good work, to speak evil of no man, to be no brawler, but gentle, showing all meekness to all men. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving divers lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. But after that, the kindness and love of God our Savior towards men appeared, not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to His mercy, He saved us by the washing of regeneration That's where we get washed by the blood of Christ. That's why I'm always telling you that bathtub at the end of the trumpet, you can see it above the white horse by washing, by cleansing us. That's what that is. Yeah. You know, and then you guys have always heard me warning you about people speaking and following this false doctrine about the Illuminati deceptions and all that stuff. Everything you need to know is in the Word of God. Everything. Everything we need to know. It's all right here. Here it says, dealing with false teachers. This is Titus again, okay? Chapter 1, verse 10. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision, whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole houses, teaching things which they ought not, for filthy lecture's sake. One of themselves, even a prophet of their own, said the Cretans are always liars, evil beasts, slow bellies. This witness is true, wherefore rebuke them sharply, that they may be sound in the faith, not giving heed to Jewish fables and condemnates of men that turn from the truth unto the pure. All things are pure, but unto them that are defiled and unbelieving is nothing pure. Remember what I said about faith, how important faith is? You've got to have that faith. But even their mind and conscience is defiled. They profess that they know God, but in works they deny Him, being abominable and disobedient, and into every good work reprobate. You know, it speaks here about, you know, how we're supposed to be one towards another. You know, showing all good fidelity, that they may adorn the doctrine of God our Savior in all things. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that, denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. You know, it's time's at hand. I mean, it's at hand right now. This is getting ready to happen. I don't feel there's very much time left. I really don't. Right here, Psalms. I told you how I doubled what Obama doubled what Bush read. 23 and 23 is Psalms 46. 7 years passed from the time that he did it. Now, this is all recorded history. You can check it out for yourself. Okay? Everybody knows in 2001, Obama doubled, or Bush read Psalms 23. You can check that out. It's all recorded in history. 7 years passed when they built the new tower, and it took exactly 7 years to build that new tower that replaced the two twin towers. And Obama doubled that. 23 and 23 is Psalms 46. And then the housing market crashed. 777 points. Okay. Then 7 years passed from Obama to when the House of Congress invited the Pope to show up into Washington. Now, I'm telling you things. I'm showing you where they've read certain things out of here, Psalms 23, Psalms 46, which was doubled. Then, when the Pope showed up, he said that Jesus Christ's crucifixion was a failure. You could check all this out. It's all on recorded history. Well, I doubled what Obama read. 46 and 46 is Psalms 92. Okay? Now, Obama, he's mocked God. The Pope, he's mocked God. Now, I come up with Psalms 92 simply by doubling what Obama did. Hey, now, this is Psalms 92, 6. A brutish man knoweth not, and neither does a fool understand this. When the wicked spring as the grass, and when all the workers of iniquity do flourish, it is that they shall be destroyed forever. But thou, Lord, art most high forevermore. For lo, thy enemies, O Lord, for lo, thy enemies shall perish. All the workers of iniquity shall be scattered. But my horn shalt thou exalt like the horn of a unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. My eyes also shall see my desire of my enemies, and my ears shall hear my desires of the wicked that rise up against me. The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. They shall still bring forth fruit in old age. They shall be fat and flourishing to show that the Lord is upright. He is my rock, and there is no unrighteousness in him. Okay, now I started off at Psalms chapter 92:6. Now I want to go back and read you the beginning. Okay, it is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises into thy name, O Most High, to show forth thy loving kindness in the morning and thy faithfulness every night upon an instrument of 10 strings. Remember David, he was playing the harp for King Solomon when he defeated Goliath, David and Goliath. Was a Solomon sound. For thou, Lord, hast made me glad through thy works. I will triumph in thy works of thy hand. O Lord, how great are thy works, and thy thoughts are very deep. I'm longing for this to be over, you guys. I know you all are too. Just really, really tired of it, especially all the bickering and stuff like that, you know, that I'm seeing. People constantly coming up against this channel. They hate this photo. You know, you can clearly see it. The angel blowing the trumpet, the white horse, and the bathtub. See, what they hate about this is it's all in line. It's all true. Jesus, I had a preacher one time in a church told me that this was a myth, that he was coming on a white horse. He goes, it ain't happened yet, so that's just a myth. And I said, what are you doing teaching the word of God when you don't even believe what's written? You know, everything else that's happened, you know, just like what I just got through telling you. You know, about Obama slandering God, the Pope, everything. And yet, these things, they ignore them. That's why I'm trying to tell you, many people right now have demonic spirits hosting them. Remember, the Lord said the devil is the ruler of this world, okay? And most people are heading in that same direction. That's why I'm constantly trying to tell people, you know, to stop while you can, you know, before it's too late, to turn, come back to the Lord now, you know, before it's too late. Here you could see a face looking down on the clouds. From the clouds, he's looking down on the earth. You see the eyes, the nose, the mouth. And then he turns his head really fast, where he's going straight. See, there's another mouth and chin right here. I believe I seen him. This one here, I seen his old face. I seen him in a store when a lot of stuff was revealed to me. See, they can make time slow down anything to where you're able to see things. Then here's the other face, which I believe this is the Lord. You know, see the mustache, the beard, here's the nose, the color of the cheek. That's originally what I took, was a picture of a rainbow. And then within an instant, it changed to that. Here's the nose, the eyes, the forehead, and that's the hair. See, they're looking down on the earth. They're not pleased with what they're seeing here. They're not pleased with this. Not everybody's going to be able to see this photo clearly. Only certain people who have eyes to see are going to be able to see it. You know, it's the same thing with that. The angel above my head, not everybody can see that. Nor can they figure it out when I say I was taken in 77 when I was 17. There's three sevens. I was 17. I'm in my 50s now. And everyone knows the Jewish calendar just switched over to 5777. What do you think would happen if the Lord was down here dwelling with us right now? Or if John the Baptist, any of them, you know, if any of them were down here right now, how do you think people would be treating them? Anybody got any comments about that? How do you, you know, give me some comments on that, a little feedback. How do you think that they would be treating all the disciples if they were here today? I don't think they'd be treating them very good. But, we need to be, making ready to get, to be seeing the Lord. You know, we should be looking forward to His coming. Everybody should. I mean, you would think so even more now because of the, just what it's all been, you know? It's been horrible. This has been horrible. I don't believe we have very much time. I know I'm here till the 11th, and then I'm packing this tent up. And if not sooner, who knows? It's up to the Lord. Only the Lord knows what's going to be happening. And back to the parking lots, you know? But I don't think we have very much time. I'll be out of here December 11th. I don't think we have very much time. I'm surprised we got as much rain as we got last night. That tent didn't hold up very good. But, that's all right. Everyone needs to be totally ready for what's getting ready to happen, okay? I'm gonna play a little tune for you here if we got enough time. Thank you. now that you use the word host. See how they use the word host? Camp host. Jesus Christ is the Lord of all hosts.